Hey everybody, how's it going? Today I'm going to take the time to kind of do a video that I've wanted to do for a while. I've wanted to do a walk around and kind of show everybody the truck and the trailer and what we have in the truck and the trailer, that kind of the special stuff we carry that helps us do our job and come out here and move the kind of equipment that we move. Tell everybody a little bit about the truck, show the inside off, and you know, just kind of give a brief walk around and kind of a look into the life of where we live at most days of the week. Right now we're sitting at a hotel. One of the small perks is we have a lot of downtime, so we spend a lot of time in hotels. We're here in Brunswick, Georgia. We got here just a couple hours ago. We're picking up a load Tuesday, going to Pascagoula, Mississippi, and then we're gonna turn around and come right back here and pick up another piece on Thursday and take it to the same place. So we have a little bit of time. I wanted to do this video because I've been wanting to do it for a while, and I have the time and I have the weather, and the truck's finally clean. We got a wash yesterday, so I'm gonna go ahead and start. This might be a little bit longer than a normal video, so I hope you guys stick around. If not, I completely understand. But all right, so hope you enjoy. So I hope you bear with me. This is the first time I'm using this newer camera for a video, so it might be a little not so professional, but I'm going to do the best I can. Okay, so you've seen the truck from the outside in pictures, so here's a little walk around and some information about it. It's a 2013 Kenworth W900L. It's got a flat top aero cab sleeper on it. It's a Cummins ISX motor with a 13-speed transmission. It's got 373 rear ends, and that's pretty much it for now. It's going to go through some changes. We're going to be adding a third axle back here, which is actually considered a fourth axle when you're adding numbers according to DOT. But it's going to go right back there, pretty much cut the frame where the mud flap is, and extend it back and add another axle the same spacing back. So that will allow us to put another 20,000 pounds of weight on the trailer or on the tractor versus what we can do now, so that'll increase our capacity that we can put on the trailer. Speaking of the trailer, it's a 2014 Ravens. This trailer, there's not going to be another one like it. It was custom designed and built by them for the guy that's mentoring me and kind of brought me under his wing and showing me into the heavy haul world. This thing is, I know you've heard me say it before, it's just an absolute monster. Nowhere we go do we have a day where somebody doesn't come up and give us some sort of compliment or ask us a question about the trailer. Most days we'll be just driving down the road and we'll get calls on the radio and what the hell do you do with that thing? And we put it to work with some heavy stuff. So it's got, obviously, as you can see, four axles. Your average trailer only has two. So this started its life as a normal two-axle, 53-foot flatbed, which this axle in the back here and this second axle were the original axles. The frame was completely redone and made heavier. The deck was reinforced. It's had two axles added, so three axles can lift. And that's all controlled by these little buttons down here, or valves down here. So we can lift the front axle, the third axle back, the fourth axle back, and we can exhaust all the air out of the airbags and put the trailer, and we'll put the mud flaps, they'll be on the ground. So the second axle is the only axle that's fixed on the ground, so we can put the other three axles in any configuration we want, which is really nice for going through states, or if you get into a really tight spot. You know, some of these shippers or consignees, they're not really designed for trucks, and you really need to be able to maneuver it around. So we can pull every axle off the ground except for this one and really get some good pivot on the trailer. As far as the outside of the truck goes in the trailer, that's pretty much just the down and dirty run through of it. This headache rack was custom built by Ravens Trailers as well. They did a killer job on it and they took real good care of us. So if any of you guys are in the trucking world and you need some custom fabrication done, you definitely need to check them out. Ravens Trailer in Dover, Ohio. Whoop whoop, shout out.
Okay, so I'll start from the front back and just go through the interior real quick, and then I'll run you through the trailer and all our toolboxes. So you'll have to excuse the mess. It's we're in a gravel lot out here, so the carpets got all destroyed, but we just had the truck washed and we cleaned it all up, so it should still be in good condition. Anyways, this is the interior. It's pretty basic, I guess you would say, for what a Kenworth tractor is. We've got just our standard gauges, whole bunch of stuff we have to monitor under there. We've got our touchscreen entertainment system, that you would say, but it also has a lot of functions. It shows extra gauges. I can see six other gauges that are all digital on that. I can control the radio and all that good stuff. I can also see any faults on the truck. I can it will give me a readout of all of that stuff. And then let's see, we got our CB radio there, and we got our light controller there, which I've already done a video on. And then going into the back, that's pretty much it. Oh, you can't forget the fucking G-Money shifter right here. That was actually a total fluke. I did not expect it to be that tall when I bought the piece that extended it, but whatever, we're rolling with it. And then we get into the back, and we've got the sleeper compartment. That's our bed that we sleep on, and this is our cabinet where all our clothes are. Give you kind of a quick run through back here. In here, we've got all our clothes that hang. All our shirts and ties and pants are all hung in here. Up here is kind of my dad's area. He keeps all his like t-shirts, underwear, socks, hats, and stuff. Up here, we have like a spare electronics bin for all the chargers and cables, and we got a scanner here for when we have to scan paperwork. This is like various health stuff, hand sanitizer, hand warmer, butt powder, all sorts of stuff. These are kind of our work shelf. Is our fire retardant suits, we've got our rain suits, we've got our hard hats with our safety vests in there. And then the rest of it, being winter, is just kind of various cold weather stuff. We've got lightweight hoodies and stuff up here, and we have heavier jackets over here, and then my heavy coveralls, my dad's heavy coveralls, our beanies, a couple more hoodies over here. And here's our cleaning bin, I guess. We've got all of our laundry stuff, fabric softeners, our dryer sheets, laundry detergent packs, our smell good sprayer that goes every once in a while. In here is kind of our electronics place. It's where we store all of our laptops. And when the seat's pulled forward, bear with me, when the seat's pulled forward, this kind of drops down into a little desk, which makes it nice. We've got our printer down there to print all of our permits and our paperwork and stuff. This is kind of like our go-to organizer. Carries all of our paperwork for our trips. Our Bible. Can't go anywhere without this. All of our receipts that we keep, that we file every month, and all of that fun stuff for the end of the year tax season. And yeah, so that pretty much covers the inside of the truck. I mean, there's not really much to see in here, nothing really special. It's just your average truck going after it, you know? Okay, so I'm gonna climb back outside here, and we'll go through the headache rack next. Okay, so like I said, this cabinet was custom built. We opened this first bin here. We've got chain pockets. These are another thing that was custom designed. Idea came from my mentor, and we kind of took it and made it work for us. We've got racks here to hold all of our binders. We've got three different size chains that we carry. We've got, these are 20-foot, 3/8-inch chains. And then these two are 10-foot sections of that same rated chain. And then these six down here are all 6-foot sections of those chains. We've got some various cut-up straps that we use for edge protection and whatever when we get a load that we don't want to scar up. And then in the middle one, middle door is pretty much empty. We hold our bungees in there. Those are spare hooks for our chains, so if we need a second hook on the end of one of those chains, we'll grab it out of there, put it all together, and it works pretty well. We've got another place to hang chains and binders if we need. Right now we don't need to, so we don't have them hanging there. We do hang this chain, our dunnage chain and binder, from this rack when we don't have dunnage, which is pretty much never, because we almost always need wood. And then this far other bin is pretty much exactly the same as the left. We've got a couple more bigger hooks down here that are, if you have a piece of equipment that's got a specialty tie down on it that you can't get a chain through, or they don't want you to scar up, you hook one of these chains to it and you run it to the end of your chain and you're good to go. Some more binders here, another 10 foot 10 foot 20 foot, and then a 20 foot 10 foot 10 foot. These are all 6 foots again, so we have 24 chains in total, and we have that many binders as well. So we got some spare wood down there to help crib or block or beat whatever we need to into place. There's a lot of hefty work that goes into kind of getting things to sit and do the things that you want it to when it's sitting on your trailer. So our light bar setup, these are Hella Mini Light Bar 200s. Great light bars, I love them. We bought them kind of on a whim, not even a company I knew made light bars. But they're great. They've got like 27 different flash patterns. They're bright as hell, and we love them so far. This thing is an auto feel 52 inch LED light bar, floodlight, whatever you want to call it. This thing was super cheap on Amazon, and it's held up so far. If it breaks, I'll just buy another one and whatever. Okay, so that pretty much, well, I guess that doesn't take care of the truck. We have two more toolboxes on the truck, on this, what we call our side boxes. And this side, it's, that was already unlocked. On this side, we have kind of our emergency kit, or this is fluids and stuff for the truck. So we've got some antifreeze, we've got some grease so that we can run through all the grease points. We've got some oil, we've got some oil stabilizer, we've got some fuel treatment, some tire shine, which is always important, engine degreaser, WD-40, which you can't go anywhere on a truck without, some spare rags for when we're doing our pre-trips and checking oil and stuff. The most important tool we carry on the truck, zip ties. Our kingpin lock for our trailer, our winch bar, our two sets of warning triangles, our air hose, which we can connect to our airlines on the tractor and run air tools. Our extension cord, which we can plug into the truck and run all the way back to the end of the trailer. And that takes care of that box. And then we got another one on the other side. And this is our tool, our real tool toolbox. So it's probably looks like a mess to most of y'all, but trust me, it's organized and we know where everything is. This is our general tool bag. Obviously, it's got pliers, it's got screwdrivers and wrenches and ratchets and drill bits and everything in here that we're going to need to work on the truck. In this little canvas bag up here is our electrical bag. It's got all of our wire strippers, our crimpers, our butt connectors, our spades, and everything that we can need to wire anything on the truck. There's a full socket set. We have a full Dremel set. This is spare parts that we carry for the truck. Lights and bezels and all sorts of stuff. Any pretty much anything that goes on this truck, we could be able to fix it with what we have in this box, which is vital to an owner operator's success, being able to take care of your own stuff and maintain and fix what you need to fix without having to pay out the ass for a truck stop to do it. So that takes care of the tractor and onto the trailer. We've got 6 toolboxes on the trailer and all of them are full. We use every bit of room that we've got in every toolbox here. We've got a ladder so that when we have a big tall piece that we have to tarp, we can climb up there. I think that thing extends to like 13 feet or something like that. We've got some rubber mud flaps, which if you're a flatbedder right now and you are just getting into it, or even if you've been into it a long time, those things are like 10 bucks at any truck stop and they are the best investment you can make. We use them as friction pads. So it's an aluminum deck. When it gets wet, it gets slick. It turns into an ice skating rink. So you put those down and you put your dunnage or your piece on top of it, and those will prevent that load from shifting under most conditions. They're vital. We use them on every single piece that we load. We use rubber mats in some way. We got some felt pads to lay over a piece before we tarp it. A lot of the stuff that we pull is multi-million dollar pieces of equipment, and the last thing they want is the tarp, which is supposed to protect it, to beat the hell out of it and scratch it. This middle one's gonna be all of our straps and our protectors. So we've got a shitload. These are all 30 foot by 4-inch straps that go to these, and they go across the trailer into our winches. We've got 4-inch straps, 2-inch straps. We've got corner protectors for our tarps. We've got edge protectors for our straps. Some of the bigger V boards for if we, for some reason, have something that's fragile but still needs to be strapped tightly. That pretty much takes care of that box. And we've got some various other rubber pieces that we've cut up so that when we run our chains together, we can run these in between the two chains so we don't lose rating on our chains. Sorry about that. Camera died. All right, so moving on. This one just has one of our tarps, one of our big lumber tarps. This tarp is 24 feet long by 27 feet wide, and it's weighs about 110 pounds, probably 115 maybe. It's a beast to lug up onto the trailer and lug up onto some of the big loads, but I guess it could be worse. We actually carry two of these. One of the other ones is on the other side, and you'll see that here in a minute. That's it on this side. You know, going down the trailer, we have a lot of these things. These are chain pockets. We can hook our binders to these, and it gives us just a better securement point than on the rub rail itself. But we can secure to all this. We have two ports on the on each side of the trailer. Actually, I think there's three. No, there's two of them on this side, and then there's two on the other side. And I'll show you what those are for, but there are two on this side. Some flag holders. These are our flashing oversized lights. They get turned on in here. They won't turn on now because I don't have the power to the trailer going, but that switch will flip those on. And that's just Mr. Donovan's School of Trucking way of protecting the switch. Another flag holder, more chain tie down things. Here's another one of the oversized light accessory plugs. Got a car hauler pulling in next to us. Please don't hit my trailer. All right. This box holds another one of our big lumber, there's two of them. They're extensions for our lumber tarps. So our tarps currently are what they would consider 6-foot drop tarps, and these extend those to a full 8-foot drop tarp. So there's two of those per tarp. We got more pads and blankets and shit in here for protecting loads. This is another full tarp. This is a 16-foot by 30-foot machinery tarp, so it's much lighter than our lumber tarps. But it's a little bit thinner, so it's more prone to taking a beating and getting holes in it. So that's when we really have to use the protection pads on them. All of our winches, these are what the straps come from and into, and you spin them and crank down on them and it tightens the straps down. So here's our, other lumber tarp. Same as the other one, 24 by 27. We got all our tire chains for our snows, or when it snows. We've got some more blankets. This one's here just to protect the box from all of our loose binders that we don't have a place to store. I think there's another like 12 binders in here for, you know, extra from what we have in the headache rack. And then moving on to our last box. This one holds more of the friction pads. Man, when I told you we use them on every load, I wasn't lying. We've got tons of them here, all different, all different sizes and thicknesses so that we can really use anything we want, any way we want to make sure that load's not going anywhere. We got some more pads here, got some windshield wiper fluid. Up here is where all our flags and banners are rolled up. This one's for the front, the other one's for the back. These are for all the corners of the loads. We've got some spare oversized lights that we can turn on. These are battery powered, they blink. Some states, when you run at night with overdimensional loads, you have to stick these on the side of the load on the widest part so people can see them. Two more of those, magnetic bases on both of them. And these little ports I was telling you about, what they are is these, I don't want to pull one out of the plastic, but they're just pigtail cords that plug into here. And then we can plug it into this light, and it'll extend all the way out to the edge of the load, magnetize it onto the side of the load, and that will power the lights for us out there so that we're not trying to run all sorts of haggard ass wires all over the place. It makes it really nice and really convenient and really reliable setup. So that takes care of the last toolbox on the trailer, and that actually takes care of just about everything on the truck and trailer. This box is a pain in the ass. I'll get it later. So yeah, hopefully if you guys were interested, you got some of your questions answered about some of our equipment. And if you guys are just completely bored, well, I apologize. So that's it. I'm gonna go back up to the hotel room and kind of relax for the night, find out what we're gonna do for some food later, and edit this video together. Hope y'all have a good day. Thanks for watching.